people of the internet, my name is Johnny, and Illumix is trying to hide something from us. That's the only opening I can think of for this video. This is so strange. So basically, we have two things that we're going to talk about in this video, starting off with the merchandise for FNAF AR, and then secondly, moving into some scrapped content from the planning stages of the game. Way back when they were figuring out, okay, what exactly are we trying to make with this brand new augmented reality experience with Five Nights at Freddy's? And I say they're trying to hide something from us because the article in which we got this information from has been edited to where it no longer contains the information, the important information that you see in the title, in the thumbnail. So, if you're brand new to the channel, please make sure you're subscribed, or if you think you're subscribed, double check. While you're down there, make sure you thumbs up the video. And now let's talk about merch.fnafar.com. So if you don't know, Illumix actually did something very incredible and something that I actually give them props for. They started what is so far the only official FNAF merchandise store created by the developers of FNAF. It's called merch.fnafar.com, and it has exactly what you think, merchandise based off of FNAF AR. And in my opinion, they actually had some pretty solid stuff on there. A lot of interesting designs with brand new renders of the characters, a huge range of different products from socks to mugs to hoodies, posters, keychains, stickers, everything. And for, in my opinion, what was a pretty decent price. It was sometime around November where they celebrated the 1 year anniversary of the game. But that was the last we heard about FNAF AR merchandise. I believe sometime in December, Kieran, the CEO of Illumix, said that they are working on something very special for merchandise, but we never really gotten anything. In fact, a couple months ago, everything on the store completely sold out. Not like people bought it, everything just randomly sold out for no reason. And it was like that until maybe like a week ago, where the entire store just went blank. Like, there was nothing on the website. Everybody was so confused, we thought that maybe Illumix had lost their license. But then they decided to put this up on their website. So long story short, for some reason, their whole merchandise website shut down completely, had nothing on it, only to, a couple days later, throw up a random PNG saying more soon with the website link. I don't know why this was necessary, but I guess it's good to know that more stuff is coming soon. Honestly, I like the merchandise around FNAF AR. I think Illumix actually does a very good job on it. I, in fact, wouldn't be mad if they stopped making FNAF AR and only made merchandise, because again, in my opinion, I think they do a pretty good job. So after like half a year, I'm super excited that we're getting more stuff. I just don't see why any of this was necessary, you know, shutting down your whole website just to say, oh, actually, we're pumping out more stuff soon. Now, we don't know when we're getting new stuff, we don't know what we're getting, so we're just gonna have to wait and see. But that is what's going on with FNAF AR merchandise. And now let's talk about scrapped content for FNAF AR in the early planning stages for the game. A ex-employee of Illumix put out an article, basically, explaining what they did when they worked on the game, showing some early concepts of the workshop and icons, and it's all some pretty interesting stuff. We're gonna go over the base article and then we'll hop into some of the more interesting things that got deleted off of the page. It starts off with a bit of backstory about FNAF AR, the game, and also the employee. FNAF AR is a mobile AR game where you scavenge and fend off rogue animatronics. User interface style. I was hired contract to help define the look and style of FNAF AR. The goal was to take inspiration from all the previous games with a focus on a workshop blueprint type style for a narrative of the game. And it shows off images of, I believe, the old workshop and also the old leaderboard. Then you have the old user interface for the game itself, and then you have the old UI for the devices. And finally, a trip down memory lane. This is the old way you encountered animatronics. For those of you who are new to FNAF AR and weren't there at the start of the game, basically animatronics would come to you into your house as they appeared on the map. So you see Springtrap over there, he'll slowly make his way towards you and then he'll enter your house. You know, kind of the whole point of animatronics coming to my house instead of, oh look, there's a random blue icon, I'm gonna click on it, oops, I'm in a fight now. If you can't tell, I missed the old gameplay. I think it works so much better with the game. We ended up with a clean blueprint modern UI style, but up with a little bit of grit and wear and tear in the minor details like the iconography. The iconography! Where I wanted FNAFior to shine was in the unique iconography. I wanted the icons to feel like they were almost clean modern icons, but with a dark twist similar to the tone of the game. I went through many, many different styles and iterations on the icons, and it was the most challenging and fun part of the project. And then it shows off some of the map navigation icons. You can see the workshop, the map, the camera, the emails, the shop, and then also the icon when an enemy entered your house. Then you have the devices icon. I don't know the names of some of these, nor do I really know where they all come from. Going left to right, top to bottom, you have the salvager, I think. I think that's like the shocker or something. Then you have allure, and then you have the EMF something. Then you have the transponder, then you have some other device, or maybe that's the EMF thing. I don't know. Then you have the battery, and then you have a triple lure. I don't know where that comes from. And then you have a radar, which I don't believe we actually see in the game at all. And then you have the camera icons, of course, the shocker, the flashlight, and the cancel button. And then the headphones icon, which appears at the very start of the game when you boot it up. The icon style we ended up with has a little bit of grudge and grime to it that makes it slightly off from the sleek modern design. And that is actually where the article stops. I'm gonna link it down below, and if you read it, that's all you're gonna get. However, again, as I mentioned earlier, this has been edited. It removed some very interesting stuff. Stuff that involves Funtime Freddy. Stuff that involves Lefty. Stuff that involves earlier concept ideas of the workshop blueprints. I would not be surprised if Illumix reached out to this person and said, hey, you shouldn't show this. Some of it's not in the game, or some of it we just don't want getting out. But of course, when you put something out on the internet, it's there forever. We have some early icons for what I can only assume to be the workshop. It seems like they were still dead set on having the Freddy icon with a wrench, but it seems like they wanted to go through a few different locations, I guess, for the wrench. You can see sometimes it's in Freddy's head, sometimes it just makes up his head, sometimes it's next to him, and then sometimes you have a wrench and a screwdriver in his head. Here are some early concept ideas for more of the icons. Looks like more of the shop, the camera mode, and also maybe the workshop as well. Seems like maybe they were trying to go for, okay, I'm repairing these guys in my own home, or it could be an actual workshop, you know, a building where you go into to take care of these animatronics and alter them. Then you have different icons for the map. It looks like they were debating going with a compass, an actual paper map. Then you have a different icon for the emails. You have loads of different icons for the shop. Seems like they were debating going with a shop building or a shopping bag. And then for camera mode, they were either gonna go with an actual camera or a camera lens. It looks like these are icons where a character has entered your house. As you can see, it has a danger icon with a shocker in it, or it has an angry Freddy icon with a caution or shocker sign above his head. And here are some early designs for the workshop itself. So as you can see, it seems like they were definitely going for that blueprint environment. Right, you can see a whole lot of blue blueprints in there. There's also some green, some reds. You can see some map UI changes as well. It looks like at one point, if you pressed a single button on the map, it would open up four different icons where you could go to, presumably the email, the camera mode, the shop, and also the workshop. You can see other designs for what I believe is the workshop itself, and then also the devices submenu. Early designs for the account, and then you can also see Mr. Cupcake in the account UI, I think that's what it is. Seems like maybe you could use him as an avatar, I don't know. And then here you have the icons for the characters themselves. So you have Freddy, Circus Baby, Springtrap, Bonnie, Plushtrap, Lefty, the Endoskeleton, Funtime Freddy, Foxy, Chica, and Balloon Boy. The Lefty and Funtime Freddy icons we've seen already. Not only were they in the game's files at some point, but they also appeared in that, like, New Year anniversary image, I think last year, in 2020. They were on a gift box, and that was our first actual evidence that, okay, these guys are coming to the game. And here, this is actually how they made the icons themselves. So it seems like they took the head of the characters and just simplified it a bunch. Right, you can see Balloon Boy, Plushtrap with different textures. We're gonna get back to that in a second. Foxy, Chica, the Endoskeleton, and the main topic for this video, Funtime Frickin' Freddy. So before we hop into Funtime Freddy, I want to explain quickly why he's still not in the game. Of course, I don't know the full story, I'm not a Lumix, but we can use Plushtrap as an example of why he's maybe not in the game yet. So as you can see, Plushtrap has some different textures than what he has in the final game. Now of course, because this was made by an ex-Lumix employee, I don't think that they can actually use these anymore, which is why they had to make new textures for Plushtrap. And so now, let's take a look at Funtime Freddy. This is insane to me. The fact that we finally, after all this time, we finally have his appearance in the game. Like, even though they can't use this anymore, this is what he's gonna look like in the game, basically. Now again, I don't know exactly why he's not in the game, because they could just do what they did with Plushtrap and just give him new textures. But very clearly, there is something stopping them from doing that. Because if it was that simple, he'd already be out in the game, you know? And I don't think it takes a year and a half to just retexture a model. But yeah, this is the official render of Funtime Freddy 4 FNAF AR Special Delivery. Again, super surreal that we finally have it, even though he's not in the game. Again, I don't know what's going on with the Lumix. They don't want to make characters. I don't know what's taking them so long, and I hate to make this a rant video, but you have his model! Again, even if this was made by an ex-employee, all you have to do is change it a little bit. That's exactly what you did with Plushtrap, so just do the same thing. I'm hopping in quickly because I completely forgot to talk about the website that this guy helped create. They say web design. Lastly, on the project, I mocked up some web design visuals for their game webpage for mobile and desktop. Now, if you don't know, FNAF AR has an official website, FNAFAR.com, but it's kind of not anything special. All it does is link you to the download pages for the game. But as you can see, these mock-up designs for the website has it a lot more colorful and vibrant and just full of energy. It still does look kind of plain, but at least it has something going on in it, rather than just, okay, here's our launch trailer and here's where you can go download the game. Right, it has news, frequently asked questions, featured news, it has an about section, it still has the download here section. Even though it is just a website, I still think this looks amazing. And it's really unfortunate that this person doesn't work for Lumix anymore, because again, all this stuff looks amazing. Lefty, Funtime Freddy, the website. It really makes you think, Lumix, what are you doing? But anyways, I just wanted to pop back in and show you the website. On with the video. I don't know, but that is some scrapped content of the early planning stages of FNAF AR. What do you guys think? I'd like to say that this is evidence that Funtime Freddy is coming soon to the game, but honestly, again, this is from like a year and a half ago. Though the fact that this was all deleted, maybe that's some evidence, but I highly doubt it. I think Lumix just wants to try and keep their secrets, you know, down a bit low, even though we all know he's coming to the game, Lefty's coming to the game. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all on the flip side. Goodbye.